Now to a story that has a lot of you talking, especially on social media right now, about what could happen in Florida. Governor Scott signed a bill today allowing permanent daylight saving time in Florida. So what does this mean? Julia Janae is joining us right now to break it down for us.
Now, Anthony, the lawmakers that supported this bill, they say it's going to do a lot of good. They say this is going to save energy, that it's going to reduce crime, and that it's going to bring down traffic fatalities. It's also supposed to help with spending. They say that there are several studies, actually, that show that there are more people are spending when it's brighter longer. Now, in a fiscal impact statement for the bill, lawmakers found that there might be some costs involved with reprogramming those devices and computers that automatically change for DST time, but the report said those costs shouldn't be too significant. The people we told about this law today had mixed reviews.
Won't affect me one way or the other. I think there's other things to worry about. You know, I'm retired, so I pick my day anyway. So
I really like that. I mean, we're Floridians. I feel like more light is good. I feel like with more daytime, it's going to be more effective for me personally, getting enough sleep to go to work and stuff.
This bill is not yet effective. It is a law, but it still needs congressional approval before it is finalized. In both Hawaii and Arizona, also two other states that we would join who are exempt from those daylight savings permanent or not time zones. Now, it's something that if it does go through by January 2019, our viewers in Georgia and our viewers in Florida may be experiencing a completely different New Year's. Anthony, back to you.